and welcome to day 16 of the holiday card series for 2012. Today I'm using this stamp set from SimonSaysStamp.com. This is called Furry Christmas, and this is a stamp set that I designed basically with three of my friends. We were sitting around a table and we decided that we wanted a stamp that represented our pets. And so, as luck would have it, our other friend Heidi was also there. And Heidi is the owner of Simon Says Stamp. And she said, well, let's do it. Let's make a stamp. So the cat in this stamp represents my cat Manny and my friend Jana's cats. And then the tall dog is Jennifer McGuire's dog Roxy. And the shorter dog is Kathy Rakusin's dog Max. So I started out stamping this out, and I was doing a few practice runs, and I did one practice run and I loved it so much, and then I started to do this other one on camera and I totally dropped my marker on it and it ruined his face. You can't really see it too much right here, but it ruined Manny's face, so I just didn't have the heart to have to redo it all. So I'm using my practice run. You'll see it right here. And I haven't finished the candy cane, and I haven't done the antlers yet either. So I'm going to go ahead and color those in now. I'm just going to erase the pencil line that I had on top. And thankfully, that second stamp that's kind of crooked, it doesn't like stamp over the one that's colored. So dodged a bullet there. Anyway, I'm going to be using Y21 and what's this other one? I think it's Y24. I'm just going to color in the antlers, really simple, using the lighter color first. And then I'm going to go in with the little bit of the darker color just along the edges, just to bring in a little bit of that color. And then I went over it again with the lighter color to kind of blend the two together. Then I colored in the diagonal stripes on the candy cane with R39. And then I'm going to cut out the animals and also the little tiny candy cane. I'm going to go around the outside edge. And the candy cane is super, super tiny. So if you can, try to cut that out first and then go in and do the animals. I did it sort of backwards, but you're going to want to be cutting everything out really carefully. So after that's cut out, you have this little itty bitty candy cane, the world's smallest candy cane in the world. And in order to prep everything before I glue on the candy cane, I'm just going around the outer edge of the cutout shape with this black Copic multiliner. It's just a black brush tip marker. And you can use almost any black marker for this, but you just want to make sure it's not going to smudge any of your Copic coloring. So I'm going to take the little tiny candy cane now, and I'm going to use some Tombow Mono Multi Glue. And I'm going to put the glue just along kind of the top edge and the curve of the candy cane so that I can sort of hang it over the end of Manny's tail and glue that on. There's also a little ornament that you can stamp on top if you're going to be coloring straight onto some paper instead of cutting it out. So I told you guys on Friday in my video that I'd show you another way or another example of how to use rock candy distress stickles and put it over the top of something that's colored. So I'm putting it over the top of Max's hat, and I'm also going to put it on the little band on the Rudolph ears or the Rudolph antlers. And so I'm just pouncing it on with this brush. I have my water nearby so that I can clean off my brush once I'm done. And you'll be able to see in the final photo how sparkly and sort of sugary it ended up looking. I think that looks really nice. So I took out my Big Shot and I'm going to cut out some paper. This is from Cosmo Crickets, from one of their 8x8 pads. And I just have these two square dies from Sizzix, and I put them down on this pattern paper, and I'm putting them in between the clear plates, but I'm having it like come out the end of the clear plates. And that's because I want to make this frame that I'm cutting, I want it to be a little bit longer than square. So by having it hang out the end of the cutting pads, it's going to prevent it from cutting all the way through on that one end. So you'll see when I turn it over that it didn't cut the other end So now I'm going to carefully remove all of the frame and everything and put it back on and extend it out. You can kind of move the dies around and kind of, they'll fall sort of back in place where they were before, like on that one end, so you can get better placement. And then I just use that same washi tape to kind of adhere it down so that it wouldn't slide around when I put it through my machine. And this time when I put it through the machine, I'm only going to have it roll through on that one end. I'm not going to roll it through all the way because I don't want it to cut that other end off. So I'm going to stop and have it go out the other way. And when I take it all apart, and it'll take a minute to get it all apart here because there was that washi tape and the two dies, but you'll see that I cut out a frame that's it's a perfectly sized frame, you know, the same width all around, but it's longer than square. It's not a square, it's just slightly longer. And I did that because the image of the animals wasn't completely square. It's a little more tall. So that's how the frame ended up. Now I'm using some marshmallow cardstock from Basil. And I seriously am having a love affair with this cardstock. It's like the thickness of Stampin' Up's regular colored cardstock, but it's white. And that's always been my big complaint with Stampin' Up Whisper White cardstock is that it's thinner than their other cardstocks, so you can't really use it as a card base. But this Basil Marshmallow is awesome as a card base. It's the perfect card weight, and it's white, and it's just lovely and perfect. So that's what I did for the card base here. I cut it down for a standard size card. I'm scoring it at 4 1/4 with this Teflon bone folder, which I normally only use to like kind of press down the fold and kind of crease it down, but I've discovered it like scores really, really well. So I've been using that recently too. So I put that down onto the white cardstock, and now I'm going to cut out a piece of craft cardstock. This is a Nina Desert Storm environmental cardstock, and I'm just making two marks where that frame is. And I cut it out so that's slightly smaller than the frame. And so I just made it a little bit off from those marks. Now I'm using this Lanfon stamp set. I think I used this on a card for this card series earlier, and I just stamped it with some frost white pigment ink and heat set it with my heat gun because I was too impatient and so I could move on. Now I'm stamping the Have a Furry Christmas sentiment from the stamp set on some cherry cobbler cardstock from Stampin' Up. Applied some white embossing powder. I'm shaking off the excess. I'm just gonna heat set that with my heat gun. And then trim around the outside edge of this little conversation bubble thing. I want it to have it popped out off the rest of the card. So I wanted to cut it out like that. So I'm adhering the craft cardstock that has the snow stamped on it. I'm going to put that kind of near the top of the card, but centered horizontally. I'm going to have this be the background behind the animals. So then I put the animals on some foam adhesive. I just used regular foam squares for this. And I adhered them down and kind of near the bottom corner. It's a little off to the right a little bit because I wanted to have room for that sentiment, the little Have a Furry Christmas. I wanted room for that. So for the frame, I cut smaller pieces out of the foam adhesive and I put it all around the frame. And then in the spot where it's going to go over the animals, I put a little thing of glue. That's because since the animals are on foam adhesive already, if I put foam adhesive on top of them, I'd have one corner of the frame that was uneven. So I just used regular glue for that spot. I adhered the frame down. And now I'm going to put two layers of foam adhesive on the sentiment. I could have just done one because it doesn't overlap the frame at all, but I wanted it to sort of stand out away from the area where the animals are. So I just did one foam adhesive right on top of the other. Put that down. Now I'm going to perform a little bit of card surgery. I decided I wanted to put some baker's twine along this, have it go vertically. So I cut two slits just right underneath the bottom and top edges of that frame so that I could feed the ribbon or the twine through those holes. So I just used the not sharp edge of my X-Acto knife to sort of push those through. You could also use a needle and actually thread it and put it through, but I didn't think about that at the time. So just wrap that around and tied it in a bow, trim off the edges. And I did the same exact thing on the top edge, except I had it tie in a knot on the inside of the card. So I added a little bit of glossy accents just over the dog's noses. And then that finishes the card for today. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I will catch you guys on Wednesday for day 17. Thanks for watching.